Welcome back to you all. In the previous lectures, we have discussed how to design a synchronous counter. Now let's take an example of designing of mode 16 counter. With the help of that, we will further illustrate the procedure. Okay. So what was the first step? In first step, we have to identify the total number of flip-flops, required flip-flops for designing of mode 16 counter. And what was the formula? This was the formula. Okay, so mod of counter is 16. So since 16 should be less or equal to 2 raised power n. Okay, we have to find such value of n for which this inequality holds. Okay, so this will be n, if this will hold for n is equal to 4. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll take 4 JK flip-flops. Why we are particularly taking JK flip-flops? Because for designing of counters, we need that toggling phenomena, and in SR we don't have this mean output, because this is indeterminate in the case of SR. That is why for designing of counter we prefer JK, or you can also go with T flip-flop. So here we have taken 4 JK flip-flop. What was the next step? The next step was to connect input of all flip-flop with 1. Here we goes, I have connected input of all the flip-flops with 1. Okay, in the next step, you have to provide an external clock to the first flip-flop. Here we goes, I have connected the clock of first H triggered JK flip-flop with an external clock. Now in the next step, you have to connect output Q1 with the clock of next flip-flop, and so on. Like output Q2 is connected with the clock of J3 or third flip-flop, and so on. So this completes the design. Okay, and so you will take output from Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. These all will be your output, where this is something very important. The flip-flop with which you are connecting the clock will give you LSB, okay, and so on. So this is, if it is your LSB, then rest of the bits will be, if it is Q1, Q2, Q3, and then Q4 is your MSB. Okay, now how will you write this output? So we first write MSB, no? So the output will be written as Q4, Q3, Q2 and Q1. Okay, that is how you can design counters, asynchronous counters. Those are having mod in the power of 2. Okay, or those who can mean the mod of the counters can be represented in the power of 2. So here we are going to have waveform representation of mod 8 asynchronous counter. We have designed mod 16, but we are going for the waveform representation of mod 8 asynchronous counter just for the sake of simplicity only. Okay, so here I have represented 3 different outputs, QA, QB, QC, where QA is representing LSB and QC is representing the MSB. Okay, so this is your external clock. This QA is the output of first flip-flop, QB is the output of second flip-flop, and QC is the output of third flip-flop. Okay, now this clock is connected with the first flip-flop. Okay, and initially we have assumed that the output of all the flip-flop is 0, set to reset to 0. Okay, at the arrival of first clock, here we have got first clock, the output of first flip-flop will toggle. Why? Because J and K both are set to 1. If J and K both are set to 1, output of flip-flop will change from 0 to 1. Okay, so here it has changed from 0 to 1. Okay, now how long it will be 1? Until the arrival of next clock. So here we have got our next clock. So our output will change from 1 to 0. Okay, now here your output has become 0. How long it will be 0? Until the arrival of next clock. So this is how you will be getting output based on this clock, and your output will become 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 and so on. Okay, now if you remember, this output is connected with the clock of QB or second flip-flop. Okay, so the output of second flip-flop QB will change in accordance to the output, this output, okay, or when the negative edge of this QA will appear. Okay, so these are the negative edges of this QA. Okay, so the output QB was initially reset to 0, it is 0. At the arrival of this edge, it has changed to 1. See how long it will be 1 until the arrival of next edge. Here we have got next edge, so here this has changed to 0. Now it will remain to 0 until the arrival of next clock. Here we have got the next clock, so your output has changed from 0 to 1 and so on. Okay, now this QB is connected to the in clock of this QC. Okay, and this is, these are the negative edges of QB. So the output of QC will change in accordance to these negative edges. So initially it was set to reset to 0, it will remain to 0 until the arrival of this edge. At the arrival of this edge, it has changed to from 0 to 1. Okay, now let's say the let's just represent them in binary. Okay, so the clock, those are representing 0th level, we will write a 0 for them, and the clock, those are representing the, like this level 1, will represent by level 1. Let's go see, this was representing level 0, so I have represented it with 0. Okay, now let's tabulate all these results. Okay, let's tabulate the result of waveform. So these are the clock 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, these are the clocks. Okay, these are the outputs. As I have told you that QC, this will be your MSB, that is why I have written it Q here, and then QB, then QA. So what is the value of QC? 4 times 0 4 times 1, that is what I have written here. What is the value of QB? 2 0 2 1 2 0 2 1. Okay, that is what I have written here. What in the case of QA, it is 0 1 0 1 0 1, so that's what I have listed here. So if you just have a look on this, what it is actually, it is representing binary numbers starting from 0 0 0 to 1 1 1. So actually this particular, this is these arrangements of output, if you arrange them in a particular way, like if we are representing QC first and then QB then QA, then it is representing, these outputs are representing binary numbers starting from 0 to 7. Okay, so this is your counter. Actually at the arrival of first clock pulse, these outputs are representing 0. At the arrival of second clock pulse, these outputs are representing 1. At the arrival of third clock pulse, this output is representing 2 and so on. Okay, this is how you can design a mod, I mean this is your waveform representation of asynchronous counters. That's all for the day. We'll discuss new things in next lecture.